I've been alluding to this concept of the law of large numbers for the last couple of videos. So I haven't used that term yet, so let's go ahead and define this term and then look back at some things I was talking about and see if we can't make that connection. The law of large numbers simply says that as the number of times an experiment is repeated, as the number of times the experiment is repeated increases, the value of the empirical probability will approach the value of the theoretical probability. I mentioned that when I did the simulation of cost of toys, or tossing coins with TC stats. What I said that is, when I physically did it with a quarter, I got like 70% heads. When I had TC stats do it 1,000 times, it was like 51 or 52%. I don't recall, I have to go back and look. Well, theoretically, it should be half, 50%. And what we did is, as we did it more and more and more, we got closer and closer and closer to that theoretical probability. Now, mathematically, we say, right there's a hat. That means the empirical probability. This arrow means, well, actually, it has a couple different means. You could say it converges to, or you could say it goes to. This is probably the two best terms. There's several ways you can actually verbalize what this means, but the idea is that this value becomes, how about becomes, what add becomes to the list? Becomes the theoretical. It gets closer and closer and closer to the theoretical as the number of times we do this increases. If we were to do the coin toss, say, 10,000 times, which I think TC stats would handle. I've never tried it, but we should try that sometime. Then what we observe as a empirical probability is going to be extremely close to the theoretical 1/2. This notation is using probability statements. And this is just using the idea of probabilities. The notation for probabilities. This is saying the empirical probability approaches pi, the true probability. So let's just say that we flipped a coin 10 times and observed 6 heads. Theoretically, we should have observed 5. We're only off by 1. We missed it by 1, which is a 10% error. So 10% error is actually pretty big. Now keep in mind here, in theory, we don't know that the probability is a half. We don't know we should have gotten 5. But in reality, it is a half. We should have gotten 5, and we're actually off by 10%. That's because my sample size, the number of times I did this, is pretty small. Now, if I did it 100 times, and to say I observed 51 heads, well, I'm still off by 1. Theoretically, we should have observed 50 heads, but we're only off by 1 again, which is now only 1% off. So you can see being off by 1 when I have a small sample size has a much bigger impact. Being off by 1 or even 2 or 3 or 4 when I have a bigger sample size has a smaller impact. And that's kind of the way that the law of large numbers actually works. Being off a few here and there when you have a large number of trials, you've done this many, 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 many times, has a smaller impact, which means you're getting closer and closer and closer to the theoretical probability.